Today, we discuss about transport of mass under diffusion phenomena. Here we explain the transport of mass under diffusion phenomena. If the two gases are brought in contact, they diffuse with each other and the physical quantity transported under the diffusion process is transport of mass. Here we consider the two gases, gas 1 and gas 2, diffuse with each other. Therefore, the concentration of the topmost layer is higher and the concentration of the layer in nearer to the OX axis is lower, and that concentration increases along positive Z direction. All gas layers are parallel to each other with the OX axis, and each layer with its neighboring layer is separated by the distance equal to lambda. Only within that distance the molecules collide with each other and they transport the mass from higher concentration to lower concentration. That lambda is known as mean free path. As the concentration is different for the different layer, the concentration gradient is established. That concentration gradient is dN by dz. Means concentration of gradient is concentration changes with respect to z axis or with respect to distance. Here we choose the three gas layers A, B and C. In that, A is the intermediate layer. That layer is reference plane or layer whose concentration is N. That concentration of the gas layer is A. Above the layer A, there is another layer B whose concentration is higher than the layer A, and the concentration of the gas molecule in the layer B is N plus lambda dN by dz, and concentration of the gas molecule in the layer C, that layer is below A, its concentration is N minus lambda dN by dz. Here the concentration means the number of molecules per unit volume. Now we have to find diffusion phenomena, the coefficient of diffusion when the mass of gas is transported from one layer to other layer. According to diffusion phenomena, coefficient of diffusion of gas is the ratio of the number of molecules crossing unit area in 1 second to the concentration gradient. Therefore, the number of molecules crossing the unit area in 1 second is d multiplied by dN by dz. Hence, according to the diffusion phenomena, we get the equation 1, that it represents the number of molecules crossing unit area in 1 second is equal to d into dN by dz. Here, as like earlier, we consider the molecules are moving in all possible directions. Means these are randomly moving. If we imagine only one third molecules are moving along any one axis, and along that axis they are moving only in one particular direction, whether upward or the downward. Therefore, 1/6 number of molecules are moving along each axis in any one particular direction. These number of molecules moves with average velocity c bar. Hence, c bar by 6 represent the number of molecules moving along each axis in one direction with average velocity c bar. Then it is possible to find the net number of molecule crossing the unit area of the layer A in unit time in downward direction as well as upward direction. That term we calculating firstly. Here we calculate the number of molecule crossing the unit area of the layer A per second as follow. First we calculate the number of molecules coming from the layer A, the layer B coming from the layer B, and they cross the unit area of the layer A per second in the downward direction. That time which term we know? What is the concentration of the molecule in the layer B? And once the molecules are moving from layer B to layer A, then how many molecules are crossing from the layer B to the layer A? And that term is C bar by 6. Hence, number of molecules moves with average velocity C bar along each axis in one particular direction is C bar by 6 multiplied by concentration of molecules in the layer B. And therefore, we write the equation C bar by 6 multiplied by n plus lambda dn by dz, where n plus lambda dn by dz is the concentration of the molecule in the layer B. Layer B has higher concentration as compared to the layer A and C. This is the equation number 2. Similarly, we find the number of molecules coming from the layer C and they cross the unit area of the layer A per second in upward direction. Now see here, once we write the upward direction, molecules must come in from the layer C. Layer C has lower concentration as compared to the layer A and B. How many molecules cross the unit area of the layer A per second in the upward direction? Only C bar by 6. Since only 1/6 molecule moves with average velocity C bar are moving along each axis in particular direction. That particular direction is upward direction. Hence, we write the next equation C bar by 6 multiplied by n minus lambda dn by dz. Now we know both direction. Number of molecules move moving in downward direction and number of molecules moving in upward direction. Therefore, we calculate the net number of molecule crossing unit area of the layer A per second. We use the equation 3 and 4 and find the net number of molecule crossing unit area of the layer A per second. That term is C bar by 6 into bracket n plus lambda dn by dz. This is the equation number 2. C bar by 6 is common, minus equation 3, n minus lambda dn by dz. Now simplify the bracketed term. Here is plus n minus n. It gets cancelled. Plus lambda dn by dz minus minus plus lambda dn by dz. Therefore, bracketed term is 2 lambda dn by dz. And we get the equation c bar by 6 2 lambda dn by dz. Again, simplify 2 by 6. That is 1 third c bar lambda dn by dz. This is the equation number 4. That equation 4 represent net number of molecule crossing unit area of the layer A per second. Equation 4, net number of molecule crossing unit area of the layer A per second is same as equation number 1. Equation 1 is writing from earlier according to diffusion phenomena. That equation is known. Therefore, we write the equation 1 and equation 4. We get dTn by dz is equal to 1 third c bar lambda dn by dz. Dn by dz is common, cancelled, and we get t equal to c bar by 3 into lambda. Means the coefficient of diffusion is represented by the equation 1 third c bar lambda. Now we express this diffusion coefficient in terms of coefficient of viscosity. Now we simplify the equation 5 by multiplying to the numerator and denominator by rho, density of gas. Therefore, equation becomes d equal to c bar by 3 into rho by rho into lambda. We get the one term we know, 1 third rho c bar lambda is the coefficient of viscosity. Therefore, d is equal to eta by rho. Yes, this is the one equation relation we get. That relation represents the coefficient of diffusion and coefficient of viscosity related by that equation. Means equation 5 simply gives the coefficient of diffusion, and this equation is 1 third c bar lambda. And in terms of viscosity, equation A is d is equal to eta by rho. Now we find the dependence of diffusion, coefficient diffusion on temperature and pressure. Now, which are the factors affecting on diffusion of gas? These are temperature and pressure. How temperature and pressure depends on diffusion of gas? As the relation, you know, d equal to 1 third c bar lambda. In that equation, lambda is directly proportional to T by P. Pressure is inversely proportional, and mean free part directly proportional to the temperature. And C bar, you know, directly proportional to square root of absolute temperature. Put these two terms in this equation and we get D is equal to D directly proportional to T by P under root T. Therefore, numerator term is t into root t, that is t raised to 3 by 2. Denominator term is simply p. Therefore, we again simplify d directly proportional to t raised to 3 by 2 divided by p. It means coefficient of diffusion is directly proportional to t raised to 3 by 2 and inversely proportional to pressure p. And that is the term we completed here. Coefficient of diffusion, that is transport of mass. Thank you.